5A state championship. It's Milk Bowl 2009, presented by the United Dairymen of Idaho, and we are ready for kickoff between these two great Treasure Valley teams. The kick is away. It is well deep into the end zone for a touchback when Eagle will take over on their own 20-yard line. First and 10 for the first offensive series of the game. And if you're going to talk Eagle, you got to talk BJ. You got to talk Taylor Kelly, the quarterback.
Just a supreme athlete, a very cerebral quarterback. He understands the game. He understands coverage. He checks in the run game. They give him a lot of responsibility. And so far this year, he's responded.
Taylor Kelly, of course, a senior quarterback, 68% passing on the season, 2,348 yards passing, 21 touchdowns, just 4 interceptions, plus nearly 1,000 yards rushing as well. This guy can do it all, and he is in the shotgun formation to start out the game against Capital. Taylor Kelly fakes the handoff, keeps it himself up the middle, and the first thing we see is a 9-yard gain from the big quarterback.
The offense isn't so much about power. It's about angles, leverage, and letting Taylor make the correct read and making the defense choose what they want to stop.
Taylor Kelly, no running backs in the backfield with him. There's 4 receivers to the left, 1 to the right on 2nd and 1. Calling out signals. Kelly looking off to the left flat. About a 2-yard gain before he's driven back by a host of Capital players. Did not quite see, BJ, who made the catch on that?
That was Braden Lee with the short gain there, I believe.
Braden Lee.
Senior receiver.
26 receptions on the season, 371 yards and 4 touchdowns. Let me give you the starting lineups for Eagle. Of course, Taylor Kelly, the quarterback, Dylan Lukart, and Mike Zarian are your typical running backs, and a whole host of receivers I'll get to in a moment as we have 1st and 10 with the ball on the 31-yard line of Eagle. Again, like the pistol formation, a handoff Kelly kept it, and it gets taken down for, we'll call it a 3-yard loss on the play. When I was asking Coach Paul Peterson for starting lineups, he gave me, 14 offensive starters instead of your typical 11, which included several receivers, including Braden Lee, already has 1 reception. Jordan Thompson is the leading receiver, along with Jason Lane, Mark Cooper, Maya Spotty, and Jeff Sloniker, the receivers, as we come up on 2nd and 13, ball back on the other side of the 30-yard line. Inside handoff this time to Dylan Lukart, and he breaks it around the left side, takes up a lot of yards before he goes out of bounds, nearly out of bounds at the 40-yard line is where they will mark it, where he was taken down by the big Kyle Sosnowski for Capital.
Very, very patient run there by Dylan. He just let his O-line work. He found a little seam on the outside and popped it down the sideline for a nice gain.
And it is that offensive line is Spencer Ford, Nolan Knuth, Justin Whiteman, Dallas Mendiola, and Nick Makua. As another inside handoff to Lukart, I believe, and he is going to get the first down, taken down by Kenneth Weathers, one of the big hitters on that Capital defense.
I think what you see early is Eagle really trying to get something established on the ground, control the clock, and force Capital to make something out of their offensive possessions by making them work hard on defense, get the ball back.
We see that set again with 4 receivers off to the left, 1 to the right, and no running backs in back to help Taylor Kelly. He rolls out to his left, has an open receiver downfield. It is complete as he goes out of bounds after a 15-yard gain, and I believe that was Maya Spotty with the reception for a nice gain there, and boy, they just flood that zone there, don't they, BJ?
Yeah, they're overloading. Capital at this point decided not to adjust to the extra man to the field, and Taylor this time got the deep man. After earlier they had the same formation, he found the short guy, so he's just playing a little cat and mouse with the corner.
So into Capital territory on the 42-yard line, 1st and 10 for Eagle. It looks like the pistol